Yo, what is up, guys? I know it's been quite a long minute since I've seen you guys back here on YouTube, but let me explain. That's why I wanted to make this video, to kind of update you guys on what has been going on. I think the last time I was actually here and active on YouTube was when Ip Man 4 came out. We did our Ip Man fan film along with the release of Ip Man 4, and it was a huge success. The video blew up. Even Donnie Yen shared it on his Instagram story, which was dope. I think that was the last time, and even then, that time we were already pretty busy. So let me explain what has been going on. So see, we still haven't forgotten about the dream. Some opportunities came by for Marshall Club, opportunities that we just could not have turned down. We were working in movies. These opportunities kind of came out of nowhere. It was pretty crazy because we were grinding pretty hard on YouTube and on social media, just putting our name out there, you know, and then when these opportunities came by, they kind of just came like that. And just one right after the other. So we were working on two pretty big ones, possibly to a theater near you. Keep an eye out. Yes, it was really hard for us to manage YouTube at the same time. And even between all of that, we were shooting, I think we were prepping for the first movie. We were shooting Ip Man, and then I was editing it in between while we were prepping for the movie. It was wild, and because we really wanted to keep up with YouTube, you know? It's our roots. Yeah, I guess you can say it's part of the journey, right? It's part of the dream. It's living the dream, right? We, Martial Club, we started here on YouTube to kind of put martial arts back on the map, bring back good martial arts action cinema, pay homage to those who came before us, but at the same time, we want to elevate it. You know what? When these movie opportunities came by, it's a good stepping stone. It really is. It's part of the natural progress. I wish I could say more about these movies, but I can't. I signed a non-disclosure agreement, but just keep an eye out. You guys will know once you guys see it. If you guys have been keeping up with us on Instagram, maybe you guys might get a hint. Wink, wink. But technically, we finished the first movie at the beginning of this year, and I flew out to Australia to work on the second movie. And before we barely got started. We haven't even shot that much, actually. I haven't even shot that much. This whole COVID-19 pandemic happened. The production's shut down. And they sent us all home, and we gotta come back to finish later on, but I mean, whenever this whole pandemic is over. So I'm home, and I'm happy because I get to create YouTube content again for you guys. It's just we're very limited because of the whole lockdown, you know, and the quarantine. But there's still a lot for me to work on. It's not like I'm not doing anything sitting at home. I still got a lot I want to do, and of course I get to train. I just got back. I got to quarantine myself for 14 days away from my family. So the 14 days is almost up, actually, but I've been staying in this room, in this back room away from the house, isolated away from everyone. And I made myself a little training area, as you can see. Let me give you guys a little tour, actually. All right, guys, so here's the little quarantine area that I'm kind of limited to, which isn't bad, actually. I made the most out of it, as you can tell. I'm kind of locked out in the back room of my house, away from my family. So I busted out some old puzzle mats that I found back here to create a little training floor. It's not that much space, as you can see. It's like, what, 5 panel mats? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. It's not that much. These weapons mainly are just for display, I will admit. Well, 80% for display. Sometimes I actually do bust them out and play with them, because when it's just hanging out here and sometimes you get bored, you just pick up a weapon and you just start playing with it. This is from a set piece from a short that's gonna come out very soon, and you will see. I got some weights, not that much lying around at home, but you make do with what you got. You don't have that much weights, make it burn. You do high reps, and as long as you challenge yourself, your body's just gonna adapt to it, right? And if not, I got an old resistance band lying around. I put up this old softbox. Just the thing, that's the good thing about doing YouTube for a while. You kind of know how to light your stuff a little bit. So I created a little bit of a mood for me to train in. It's a little heat dish that I have because it gets cold back here, but I leave it on for when I'm training. Pre-workout energy drinks for training, my Theragun, speakers. Here's my little editing slash writing station. Right now, I'm working on Fist of Fury. I know you guys have seen part of it. If you guys follow us on Instagram, you guys have seen part of it. But the whole thing will come out fairly soon, now that I have the time to sit down and edit it. I know, like I said, because this last year has been pretty crazy. Fist of Fury has been a year and a half overdue, guys. Editing Fist of Fury, and I'm writing for the Marshall Club movie. Yes, we still plan on making a Marshall Club movie. I've been working on an idea for over like 2 years, 3 years now. And it's always changing every day, because every day you're growing, especially if you're going through different experiences and you're gonna write a martial arts story that's very personal for you. It's gonna change, and every day it's changing. So writing, it's gonna be a process, but I'm working on it. YouTube content, I wanna bring YouTube back. Obviously, yes, I know it's kinda crazy. We're working on movies now. We're kinda moving our way up the ranks, but you can't forget your roots, you know? The fans who support you in the beginning. You gotta stay real, you know? Started on YouTube grinding a lot of the times for nothing. We got nothing out of it doing YouTube. We really just wanted to spread. And as far as we go, we're gonna stay true to what we believe in. Just starting to break into these small roles in these movies. It's a stepping stone for sure. Like, dude, even Donnie and Jackie Chan, when they first tried to break into America, they had to do like these small roles. Dima, Brian, and I had a meeting yesterday, you know, just to regroup and just talk about how we're gonna move forward, because obviously this pandemic threw a lot of things off. We talked about the future for martial arts movies, and I think how martial arts movies plays its role in society depends on the social climate, you know? Something about that social climate today is the reason why martial arts movies aren't as appreciated as it was back in the day. And we want to bring that back. I know I keep saying it. We want to bring that back. Dima's kind of a prophet, dude. He's really smart. He talked about something big that's going to happen that is going to change the social climate. And there will be a place for martial arts movies once again in society. And this pandemic might be it, you know? Like, after this pandemic, maybe the way people consume movies might be different. Maybe the people will start looking for more things that are grounded, like martial arts. And as you can see, Marshall Club is doing everything in our power to keep all doors open so we can be there the day that happens, you know? In the movie industry, on social media, on our training, you know, staying on top of everything, you know? Best believe, Marshall Club, we are going to be the next generation of martial arts action. We're gonna bring good martial arts action back. And we're gonna bring it with a new flavor. Trust me. I hope you guys are staying at home. I hope you guys are safe. Keep an eye out. Marshall Club is killing it right now. We are moving forward. And we got a lot coming in the works. And even for YouTube too, we have a lot of ideas we wanna do in this quarantine. I'm gonna go ahead and sanitize the camera. And I'm gonna hand it over to Brian. And so he can update you on his end, what he's doing on the other side of the house.
Yo, guys. Ryan Lee here from Marshall Club, you know, swole as ever. Andy just passed me the camera, so I wanted to show you guys a bit of my training space. So, unlike him, he has a little patio. I have this pull-up bar, so I am blessed. And I have the whole living room to myself. As you can see, I moved all the couches, you know, I moved all the tables, everything that would distract me. You know, I put this mattress here so it's like my own room, you know, like boom, like there's nothing. It's just me, you know? And unlike 99% of you guys, I am blessed with my home gym. So yeah, I got everything here. Everything I need here. You know, I got the 45s here. I have the 25s, I have the dimes. You know, I have the barbell here, thanks to Robo from the Marshall Club family. He was nice enough to give this to me a couple years ago, and I'm glad I'm putting it to use now. I got some bands here, you know, the heavier ones, light ones. Oh, I'm a little injured, so my rebands. But yeah, I have everything. I am blessed enough to have equipment here, so I'm strapped, I'm set, you know. But for those of you who don't have equipment, you can literally go and makeshift your own gym. When I was traveling to do this movie one time, I was placed in this hotel with no gym. So what I did was I filled the luggage up, but I took everything I had heavy in the hotel. I started rowing it, you know, I started benching, I started doing everything I can with it. I went down to the lobby, found the couch, and I started doing skull crushers and curls, you know? In the end, if you're out there making excuses, then let's be real. You are full of shit. You know, it doesn't come down to how much equipment you have or don't have. It comes down to your willpower, the warrior spirit. How much excuses you're willing to not make. Try that, huh? Because everyone can make excuses. Oh, I don't have equipment. I don't have a gym. I don't know what to do. You're a fucking liar. You have access to the internet. You can go on YouTube. You can look up home workouts. You know, there are millions of videos out there. So please do yourself a favor. Stop making excuses and tap into your warrior spirit.
All right, guys, enough training talk for now. I wanted to show you guys a bit of what I've been working on, and I'll give you a hint. It's about the founder of Kyokushin Karate. It has four of the guys from the Martial Club Stunt family. There's D.Y. Sal. D.Y. is one of the best martial artists I know. And there's the brother AJ, Robo, and Jackie, okay? So let me give you guys a little sample of what I'm doing here.
All right, that's all you guys get to see.
D.Y., Andy, and I, all the Martial Club, we sincerely thank all the supporters who've stuck around since day one, who's been there with us through the hiatus and everything. And we wouldn't be here if it weren't for you guys. So thank you. Now, mark my damn words. Martial Club will revolutionize martial arts action cinema.
What's up, guys? D.Y. from Martial Club coming at you from the safety of my own home due to the recent lockdown. And it's been different for me. I'm sure it's been different for all of you guys. Just a couple things that have been going on my end. Still training, still trying to keep in good shape, and trying to lose weight even under quarantine, even though all the gyms are closed. Still gotta find a way. So been finding ways, new ways to train at home, train at the area surrounding my house. I was training a lot at the Civic Center, which is just one block away from my house, doing kung fu there, trying to keep in shape, but it's been raining a lot recently, so I've had to get more creative, and I've been finding ways to train in my own house, in this room actually. One of the effects of the lockdown is I've had a lot of time to clean, so if you take a look around, my room is actually cleaner than it has been in years, and I mean that literally. And one of the products of that is it's cleared enough space in my room to do my training. I've been watching a lot of UFC and mixed martial arts and kickboxing to pass the time. And when you start watching a lot of it, you start getting curious. And as a result, I've been doing a lot of like kickboxing workouts online. The change of pace has been really good. I've actually been losing a lot more weight from it just because the method of training is so different than what I'm used to. And it's a way for me to expand outside of my bubble, which is what we always need to be doing as martial artists. I've been learning a lot, it's been a lot of fun, and also it's been getting my feet wet in a martial arts style that's not my wheelhouse. So I've been really enjoying that. And then other than that, I've also been trying to up the strength training. So while I'm not able to move around as much because of the limited space, trying to build up my muscle mass. I'm a little bit heavier. Hopefully you guys will notice in a good way. But yeah, it's all about keeping the mind healthy, and key to that is keeping the body healthy. So, you know, it's really easy to make excuses and get lazy during this time, but I want to encourage you guys not to do that, because we're always training. Martial arts is life, and life is martial arts. And this is just a part of life. What's going on is just a part of life. So we gotta stay strong during it, and we just gotta find ways to move past it. And so for that reason, I want you guys to keep up your training. I'm doing my best, and you guys do your best, and we'll get through this together. Also on the creative end, as you guys can see, Martial Club is back to making videos. It's really good to be back in video conferences with Andy and Brian. And just editing new videos and finding a way to expand Martial Club's channel even when the world is on lockdown. It's been an interesting challenge trying to stay active creatively as well as physically. But we're getting through it, and I'm very sure that each of us will come out of this stronger in more ways than one. I'm D.Y. I'm staying active. Hope you guys are doing well, and we'll see you on YouTube soon, alright? Peace!